What's up everyone, Howard Pinsky here with another Photoshop tutorial. Today I'm going to be showing you guys how to create a double exposure style effect in Photoshop using two photos. Now traditionally this has been an effect that photographers have been doing for a very, very long time. But if you don't know how to do this using just a camera, let me hop into Photoshop and show you how this is done. Alright, so here we are in Photoshop with a simple image that I grabbed from Shutterstock, and the first thing we need to do is select the tree and isolate it from the background. So in my tools bar to the left, I'm going to grab my quick selection tool, and if the brush is a little bit too small, the right square bracket key will increase it. And I'm simply going to brush over top of the tree. It doesn't have to be a perfect selection, but as you're brushing, Photoshop is going to start to analyze the surrounding areas and do its best to select the other areas. In this case, the leaves and the tree and the stems and all the things that grow on trees. Photoshop is going to try to include that in the selection. Now, don't worry if you're getting a little bit of the sky in the background. We're going to take care of that in a moment. So now that a basic selection has been made, we want to refine it. And there's a refine edge button right at the top. I'm going to turn on smart radius, increase the radius a little bit, and then tweak the settings down below as well. I have done many videos in the past on refine edge, so I'm not going to get too much into detail. This will allow us to create a little bit more of an accurate selection than the selection we had originally with the quick selection tool. Now to output it, I'm going to choose layer mask and then press OK. And you're going to notice that we now have our tree separated from its background. But like I mentioned, we still have some of the blue in the background from the sky. So I'm going to make sure the layer is selected, not the layer mask, and then head up to select and then choose color range. I'm going to move this over just a little bit, and then I'm going to sample the blue sky in the background, and I can change the fuzziness around to select more or less of it. I can also hold down my shift key and select a lighter or darker area to include those as well. I'm going to press OK to select the sky, and now that it's selected, I want to select my layer mask and then fill that selection with black to hide it. So black is my foreground color. I'm going to hold down Alt or Option and press Delete. And that will fill that selection with black and in return, hide it from the image. Perfect. I'm going to position this somewhere right in the middle of my document. And if I hold down Command or Control and click on the layer mask, you'll notice the selection now excludes that blue that was in the background. Now for the image I'm going to be using as the second exposure, I grabbed another image from my good friends at Shutterstock. And I'm going to simply drag this image up to the other tab and plop it right into place. And I can move it anywhere on the document if I choose. And the first thing I want to do is make sure that it's inside of the tree. So in the layers panel, I'm going to hold down Alt or Option, position my cursor in between the two layers and click. That will create a clipping mask, which still allows me to move the image and will remain inside the layer below it. Next, I'm going to go ahead and add a black and white adjustment layer at the bottom of my layers panel. And just like many of the other adjustments, there are a lot of presets that go along with it. And you can cycle through and choose the preset that looks best for the images that you're using. For this one, I'm going to stick with the high contrast red filter. Now you're probably noticing that the texture from the trees below the woman in the front is not coming through. So what we can do, we can select the layer of the woman, double click on it to open our layer styles, and we want to focus on the blend if section at the bottom. We want to blend with the underlying layer. So I'm going to hold down my Alt or Option key and drag the right side of the left slider to the right to blend the shadows and do the exact same thing for the highlights on the right. So I'm going to hold down Alt or Option, drag that slider to the left to blend the layer of the woman with the tree texture in the back, which is the underlying layer. And you can tweak this as much as you want until you have an effect that looks really nice. And once you're happy with it, you can go ahead and press OK. Now very quickly, I'm going to create a new layer, drag it to the back, and just fill it with white just so we have something in the background to work with. Now in many double exposure images, there's a nice blend between one layer and another. So what we're going to do, I'm going to select the layer of the woman and duplicate it with Command or Control J. Once that's done, I want to turn off the blend if adjustment. So I'm going to double click on the layer, slide those back to the original position, and then press OK. Now as I'm really only focusing on the skin of the woman, I'm going to grab my quick selection tool one more time, shortcut key W, and simply paint over top of her skin to turn that into a selection. Again, it doesn't have to be perfect, but I do want to make sure I select as much of it as possible so I don't have to do too much masking later on. And once I have my selection complete, at the bottom of the layers panel, I'm going to add a layer mask. Now at this point, we want to blend out the areas that we don't want perfectly visible. So I'm going to select the layer mask of this new layer, then I'm going to grab my gradient tool from the tools bar, shortcut key G, and then on the top at the options bar, I want to make sure that foreground to transparent is selected, and that my foreground color is set to black. And then I'm going to simply create a few gradients from the left to the right to blend out the left side of this duplicated layer so only the right side is clearly visible. And now that that's done, on the right side there's a few trees that are popping out. We don't want those ones visible. So I'm going to select the layer mask of the trees, grab my brush tool, shortcut key B, and with a hard black brush, simply brush those out just like this. Perfect, and that looks great, but we're noticing there's a little bit of a border around the woman when we masked her out originally. So I'm going to select the layer mask of that duplicated layer, and then simply mask the edge. This will allow me to further refine the edge so I can shift it inwards a little bit to get rid of some of the border. I can increase the contrast a touch, feather it a little bit, or even smooth it out. And when I press OK, you'll notice the border is pretty much almost gone. Now to clean it up a little bit and to add a little bit more of a transition, I'm going to turn the tree layer mask into a selection. I'm going to invert that selection, Command or Control, Shift and I, and paint with my black brush to hide the top of that duplicated layer to transition it with the trees a little bit to give a little bit more of a texture. And you may also be noticing that the right side of her face isn't 100% clear. So in this case, I can switch over to my white brush, shortcut key X, and paint in that area to reveal some of the face that may have been removed when I used the gradient tool a little bit earlier. And if I want to give the image a little bit more of a stylistic effect, I can hide portions of the bottom with a little bit of a curve so it's not too sharp. So now that the base effect is pretty much finished, there's a lot of things I can do, including adjustment layers, to add even more effect to it. As an example, I can add a curves adjustment layer to darken the shadows or brighten the highlights a little bit. I can even add a photo filter if I want to give the overall look a little bit more of a vintage style. Now the photo filter is not affecting the background because it's a pure white, so I'm going to set my foreground color to a light gray and then hold down Alter Option and press Delete. And that actually revealed a little bit more of a border around the woman, so I'm going to select the layer mask, turn it into a selection, and then head up to the Select menu, down to Modify, and then choose Contract. Bring that selection in by around 3 pixels, invert it, Command or Control, Shift and I, and then fill it with black to hide that border. I'm also going to switch over to my white brush and paint in a little bit more of her skin right around the right area where her shoulder is. That'll just give a little bit more of a transition between the woman and the trees on the left-hand side. And again, I'm going to get a little bit stylistic with a nice little curve at the bottom so it's not too sharp. I'm noticing I revealed a little bit too much around her shoulder, so I'm going to switch over to my black brush and fix that up just a little bit. Now another thing you're able to do, if you don't want it pure black and white or sepia, you can turn down the opacity of that black and white adjustment layer to introduce a little bit of color to the image. Or instead of messing with the opacity, you can simply change the blend mode from normal to soft light. And if the effect is looking a little bit harsh, you can group all the layers into a group and slightly decrease the opacity of all the layers at once. And because we've been using layer mask and adjustment layers this whole time, you can go back and make changes to pretty much anything that your heart desires. So for example, if you don't like the sepia slash color look, you can switch over to a pure black and white look. Let me know in the comments which one you like more. And that will just about complete the double exposure look in Photoshop.
And that's how you accomplish a double exposure style effect in Photoshop. I hope you guys liked it. Let me know if you like the color version or the black and white version. And if you do one of these of your own, tweet it to me at Iceflow Studios or my Facebook page, facebook.com/Iceflow Studios. Now, if you do like this video, make sure to hit that subscribe button so you're notified when I release future content. And if you really like my content, hit that Patreon button right at the top. You can contribute to my content on a monthly basis, $1, $3, $5, whatever you can afford. It would help a lot, and it would help me make better content for you guys. So thanks for watching, guys. I got some more videos and playlists right over here, and I'll see you guys next time. Take care.